Hi students, welcome back to all four C learning chemistry classes. Today we are going to start session 14 of stoichiometry, and the subtopic is again stoichiometric calculations. In the previous session we have just discussed one or two numericals based on volume calculations, and today's session I am going to discuss more number of numericals based on volume calculations. And please concentrate students, and get ready with pen and a notebook and write down along with me. So our first numerical in this session is, please write down, 40 ml of, write down students, a hydrocarbon, 40 ml of a hydrocarbon undergoes combustion. Undergoes combustion in 260 ml of oxygen under similar conditions gives 160 ml of carbon dioxide. 160 ml of carbon dioxide. What is the molecular formula of hydrocarbon? Just MF I am writing students. Molecular formula of hydrocarbon. Okay, this is the question given to us, and let us evaluate the molecular formula of this hydrocarbon given. As in the previous session, I have written a general combustion reaction for hydrocarbon, that is CXHY plus x plus y by 4 O2 gives rise to x CO2 plus y by 2 H2O. Same approach I am going to use to solve this numerical. Okay, mole ratio, volumes ratio is same because all the three are gases except H2O. Yesterday I have told you in the previous session, very clearly, if nothing is mentioned, default you should consider H2O as liquid only. You should consider that as gas only if the temperature is mentioned as 100 degrees centigrade. Don't forget about that. Okay. Now, let me write the given volumes here. 40 ml, 260 ml. Carbon dioxide 160 ml. Sir, he did not mention that oxygen 260 ml is just sufficient or any excess. No other data is given to us. So, you can simply take it as sufficient oxygen only. Okay. Now, let us go for the approach. Moles ratio is equal to volumes ratio according to Gay-Lussac's law of combining volumes. Now I am going to do this. These two combination first I will take. This by this I will take. Let me see what will happen. x plus y by 4 divided by 1 mole is equal to moles ratio is equal to volumes ratio 260/40. So simply you can write x plus y by 4 is equal to 13/2. Leave it. Next, take these two combinations. So x by 1 is equal to 160/40, that is equal to 4. So I got x is equal to 4. Substitute here, immediately you will get y equal to 10. So your hydrocarbon is C4H10. That is the hydrocarbon given to us. So this is the solution for this question. I have repeated this model in the previous session. We did the same model. In this session also I have repeated this, and then I will go for next models. You please note it down, students. Okay, students, let us go for the next question. Please note it down along with me. 20 ml mixture of 20 ml mixture of C2H2 acetylene and carbon dioxide required 20 liters of oxygen required 20 liters of oxygen for complete combustion. For complete combustion, calculate mole percent of acetylene. Right down, students, calculate the mole percent of acetylene in the original mixture. In the original mixture under similar conditions. Okay, this is the question what we have to solve now. He has given mixture of two gases, acetylene and carbon dioxide, and that mixture is undergoing combustion. Carbon dioxide is higher oxide of carbon monoxide, that's next carbon dioxide, higher oxide of carbon. So it will not undergo combustion reaction. Out of that, these two gases, only acetylene undergo combustion. That is the first point we have to identify before solving this numerical. So here, among these two, the substance which is undergoing combustion is acetylene, but not carbon dioxide. Now let us write a balanced chemical equation for the combustion of acetylene. Two carbons, two CO2, two hydrogens, 1 H2O. Now count the oxygens on right side. 2 into 2, 4 plus 1, 5. So you have to write here 5/2 O2. First three are gases. Don't consider what H2O as gas unless the temperature is mentioned as 100. So it can consider simply as liquid. Forget about that. And what exactly he is saying, when this mixture undergoing combustion, the required volume of oxygen is 20 liters. But out of this 20 ml, please correct it, students. This is also 20 liters. So please correction. Please correct it. So out of this 20 liters, how many liters of acetylene, how many liters of carbon dioxide, we don't know. That's what we have to find out now. Okay. Now, take, suppose I am writing here, mole ratio 1 by 5 mole, 1 mole, 5 by 2 moles and 2 moles of carbon dioxide, okay. Now, you can write like this, moles ratio is equal to volumes ratio. Say for example, you can write 1 by 1 volume, 5 by 2 volumes and you will get 2 volumes, whatever might be the unit of volume. Ratio should not be disturbed according to the balanced chemical equation. Okay. Now, if I take it as X letters, I don't know out of 20 how many letters of acetylene is there. So, X letters. Here, requirement is 5X by 2 liters and the production is 2X liters. So, this 5X by liters requirement is given as 20 liters oxygen is used in the combustion. It means if it is X, the utilized volume of oxygen should be 5X by 2. So, indirectly you can write here 5X by 2 is equal to 20. So, 5X equal to 40, X equal to 8 liters. Now, I got the volume of acetylene as 8 liters. Now, I can write the composition C2H2CO2 in the original mixture. This is 8 liters I got now and automatically it becomes 12 liters because total is 20. Now what he is asking, mole percent of acetylene, moles ratio is equal to volumes ratio for gases. So, mole percent is equal to volume percent. Okay, let me calculate the mole percent of acetylene, nothing but volume percent. 8 out of 20, total 20 liters, out of that acetylene is only 8 liters I got into 100, that is 40%. So, this is answer for this question. And the same question can also be asked like this. See, how many liters of carbon dioxide gas will be produced? Here carbon dioxide, how much you are written? 2x liters. How much x you got? 8 liters. So, our answer will be 16 liters. 16 liters will be produced in the combustion. So, you can get the question like this. What is the final volume of carbon dioxide after completion of reaction? In the reaction, 2x is equal to 2x is equal to 16 because x is equal to 8, 16 liters. Already 12 liters in the original mixture. So, total 16 plus 12 comes around 28 liters of carbon dioxide will be there after completion of this reaction. So, that question also can be asked. So, here I am writing. Final volume of carbon dioxide in the reaction mixture after completion of reaction, 2x liters from reaction. So, 2x means 16 liters plus already in the original mixture 12 liters. So, total it becomes 28 liters. So, another question can also be set like this, and these two questions can set under a paragraph comprehension based question based on this data. Simply give this data under the heading as comprehension. First question, first MCQ, mole percent of acetylene he can be asked. And second question under that same comprehension. So, the final volume of carbon dioxide after completion of reaction. So, this is one more model that is asking in advanced JE paper. Okay, students, I think please note it down. Let us go for the next numerical. Okay, students, let us go for the next numerical. Please note it down along with me. 200 ml of pure oxygen is subjected to electric discharge is subjected to electric discharge. Thirty percent of it will be converted into ozone. Calculate the volume of ozonized oxygen obtained in this process. That is the question, students. Let me explain the question, what exactly he has given. Here, pure oxygen is subjected to electric discharge where it will be converted into ozone. It means nothing but the preparation of ozone from oxygen. So, the equation, the reaction we have to use is oxygen should be converted into ozone. Right, the balance very simple, 2O3, 3O2. We know both are gases. Okay, leave it. Now I got the chemical reaction for this question. Conversion of oxygen into ozone. Okay. Finally, what he is asking? Volume of ozonized oxygen. It means complete all the oxygen is not converting into ozone. Only 30% of oxygen is converting into ozone. It means in the final reaction mixture, both oxygen and as well as ozone will be there. That's why he is calling that mixture as ozonized oxygen. I think now you got the idea what exactly he has asked in the question. Now let us go for the solution. So very simple, students, very simple it is. 3 mole, 2 mole. Simply you can write 3 volumes. 2 volumes. Okay, leave it. Here 30%. What is the 30% of 200? 60 ml of oxygen is converting into ozone, students. Now I am writing 60 ml into like this, see, 3 into 20 ml. Concentrate. What is the volume ratio of this? 3:2. So I made this 60 ml as 3. 3 into 20. So automatically what you will get here? 2 into 20 ml. This will be consumed. Close. And this you will get obtained. Okay. Now unreacted oxygen I am writing here. See, students, concentrate. Unreacted oxygen. Out of 200, how much has been reacted? 60. 200 minus 60, that is 140 ml. Okay, students? Produced oxygen, produced ozone, I got here as 40 ml. Okay. Now, the final volume is 180 ml, which is nothing but the volume of ozonized oxygen. See, I will repeat once again. Very simple it is. Volumes ratio, moles ratio, same, 3:2. He has given 200 ml of oxygen. 30% means 60 ml. Simply, I have written this 60 ml as 3:20. There you will get 2:20 because the ratio is 3:2. This has been consumed, that will be produced. So, out of 260 has been consumed, so unreacted oxygen is 140 ml. And the produced ozone is 40 ml. So 140 plus 40, total 180 ml, because he is asking for ozonized oxygen, that is mixture of oxygen and as well as ozone. That's why your answer is 180 ml. Students, please note it down. Okay, students, let us go for the next numerical. Write down, students, along with me, 30 ml mixture of, write down, students, I am repeating, 30 ml mixture of methane CH4 and ethylene C2H4. Methane CH4 and ethylene C2H4 of mole ratio A is to B, small letters A is to B, on combustion. Hey dear friends, on combustion gave 40 ml of carbon dioxide. If the ratio had been changed to, if the ratio has been changed to B is to A, what will be volume of carbon dioxide produced on combustion of same mixture under similar conditions. That is the question given to you, students. Okay, he has given mixture of two gases. I am writing here very clearly. Please, I will start from here. CH4, what is the other gas? C2H4. Total mixture volume is 30 ml. Please note it down, students. 30 ml volume. Concentrate. Very important question. Okay. Let me write the combustion reactions for these two. Note it down. Two carbons, two CO2, four hydrogens, 2H2, 1 carbon, 1 CO2, 4 hydrogens, 2H2O. Okay, now balance. This is 2, 4 plus 2, 6, this is 3. Now, these two are the balanced reactions for the combustion of methane and ethylene gases. Okay. First, in the ratio A is to B, they have taken. So let me take. Volumes ratio is equal to moles ratio. Volumes ratio is equal to moles ratio. Okay. Let A, say for example, out of 30 ml, I don't know how much is methane and how much is ethylene. But he has given moles ratio A is to B, nothing but volumes ratio is also A is to B. So, out of 30 ml, I don't know how many ml of this. I am going to take it as x ml. Now, this automatically becomes 30 minus x ml. Please, note down, students. X ml produce x ml of carbon dioxide because ratio is 1 is to 1. Here ratio is 1 is to 2. observe friends, ratio is 1 is to 2. So 30 minus x will produce 2 into 30 minus x ml. 2 into 30 minus x ml. That volume of carbon dioxide he has given in the question as 40 ml. Right? Let me add the total volume of carbon dioxide now. X plus 60 minus 2x equal to 40. So, x equal to 20 ml. Okay, now, I got the volume of methane, 20 ml. So, here I am writing CH4, 20 ml. Concentrate, students. C2H4, 30 minus 20, 10 ml. So, ratio 2 is to 1, nothing but A is to B. Concentrate, students. Finally, I got A is to B as 2 is to 1. A is to B as 2 is to 1. So, that's why this is 20 ml and this is 10 ml. Now, he has changed the ratio. Here also, I will repeat. Volume of methane by volume of ethylene. Say, for example, moles ratio is equal to volumes ratio. 20 by 10, that is 2 by 1, 2 is to 1, nothing but A by B, nothing but moles ratio. This time he has given B by A, B by A means 1 by 2, that is A equal to 20 ml, B equal to 10 ml. A by B, 2 is to 1, so B by A, 1 is to 2, 1 is to 2, so 1 ml B, 2 ml this. Okay, now let us calculate. I think A is to B, 20 ml by 10 ml, 2 is to 1. But he has given the ratio this time as B is to A. So it is A, 10 ml. Ratio has been B is to A changed. So 10 ml, 20 ml. So this time you have to take methane as 10 ml and C2H4 as 20 ml. Now, take this time like this, because he has reversed the ratio. A is to B is 2 is to 1, B is to A is 1 is to 2. It means, you have to take methane as 10 ml and ethylene as 20 ml second time. Now, let me calculate. 10 ml gives, no doubt, 10 ml, because volumes ratio, moles ratio is 1 is to 1. Here, if you take this one, I am writing here, 20 ml. No doubt, you will get this as 2 into 20, total 40 ml, 40 ml. So, this 10 ml, this 40 ml, 10 ml plus 40 ml. So, your answer is 50 ml, students. Don't forget about that. I will repeat once again. Very good question. He has given A is to be mole ratio or volume ratio out of 30 ml. Okay? Right. Methane and ethylene both I have taken. I have written the balanced combustion reactions. I don't know how much of methane I have considered as XML. XML gives XML. 30 minus X gives. So, 2 into 30 minus X. Total I have added, and that's one exactly he has given as 40 ml. So, that's why I have equated to 40 and I got X as 20 ml. Now, 20 by 10, remaining 10 for ethylene. So, ratio now A is to B, I got it as 2 is to 1. But what he did for the second time? He has reversed the ratio as 1 is to 2. Then, you have to take the methane volume as 10 ml and ethylene volume as 20 ml. Again, apply the same. 1 ml, 1 ml, 10 ml, 10 ml. 1 ml, 2 ml, 20 ml, 2 into 20, 40 ml. So, this 40 and this 10. So, your final volume of carbon dioxide, you have to report the answer as 40 plus 10, total 50 ml. 50 ml. Just a simple logical approach, students. Nothing more than that. Simply you can evaluate. The only thing is, you should be in a position to write the balanced chemical equation for the combustion of a given hydrocarbon. A remaining thing is, simple application of Gay-Lussac's law of combining volumes. Very simply you can evaluate. not at all. Down. A 12 grams sample of methane and ethylene yielded 35.2 grams of carbon dioxide on complete combustion. What is the mean molar mass of original mixture? That is the question. Please note it down, students. This time also has given the same gas mixture, just like in the previous question. Okay, and the data is completely different. Here masses they have given, and finally is asking for mean molar mass of that 12 grams sample of mixture. That is nothing but average molar mass of that gas mixture we have to find out. Now let me write the combustion reactions first of all. This is that is compulsory. CH4, write down students, O2, CO2 plus 2H2O, here 2O2, and one more reaction, C2H4 plus O2 gives rise to 2 carbon dioxide, 2H2O balance 3O2. So, these two are the balanced chemical equations for the combustion of methane and ethylene. Okay. But total mass of the mixture he has given as 12 grams. But we don't know how many grams of this and how many grams of this. Okay. Let me take, here I am writing, x grams methane plus 12 minus x grams ethylene. I will assume like that, students. Okay. Now, x grams methane means x by 16 moles, and this is 12 minus x by 28 moles, because molar mass of ethylene is 28 and that of methane is 16. We know from 1 mole you will get 1 mole, from 1 mole you will get 2 moles. Similarly, from x by 16 moles, how much you are going to get? Again, x by 16 mole. Okay. Now, 12 minus x by 28 moles. 1 mole gives 2 moles. So, 12 minus x into 2 into 2 divided by 28 moles. But he has given the mass of carbon dioxide. So, mole of carbon dioxide you can calculate. 35.2 by molar mass is 44, I think 8 40s are 320, 8 40s are 32, okay. This is nothing but 0.8 mole, okay. But these are the moles. So, these total moles should be exactly equal to 0.8. Is it right or not? Now, I am equating that. X by 16. Plus 12 minus x by 14, because I have cancelled this as 14, is equal to 8 by 10, that is 0.8. Anyway, you can do the calculations. For simple calculation, I did like that, nothing more than that, because 8, 7, 5, on solving x, you will get it as 6.4 grams. So, what is X here? X is nothing but methane. So, 6.4 by 16. Okay, you please note it down and then I will continue. Please note it down. Okay, students. Finally, we got x as 6.4 grams. What is x? I have considered mass of methane. I am writing now. Mass of methane. Finally, I got it as 6.4 grams. Out of 12, 6.4 as methane. So, mass of ethylene is equal to 12 minus 6.4. That is 5.6 grams, students. Now, you can calculate moles. Moles of methane is to moles of acetylene. Mole ratio I am doing, students, concentrate. 6.4 by molar mass, 16, is to 5.6 by molar mass of ethylene, 28. This is equal to 0.4 is to 0.2, that is 2 is to 1. So, the mole ratio of methane and ethylene in that mixture is 2 is to 1. Now, I can calculate mean molar mass because I got the mole ratio. So, 2 is to 1 for methane and ethylene. So, 2 into 16 plus 1 into 28 divided by 3. 32 plus 28 is 60. So, your answer is 60 by 3. So, very important one. Advanced level question it is, students. Please finish off the solution of this and then I will go for next question. Okay, students, let me go for the next numerical. Write down. 100 ml of oxygen is subjected to electric discharge to get ml of ozonized oxygen. 80 ml of ozonized oxygen. Calculate the mole percent of oxygen and the original mixture. Calculate the mole percent of oxygen in the final mixture. Mole percent of oxygen in the final mixture. In the final mixture. Okay. Same question we have discussed in a different manner. Now, he has changed the data. Let me write the equation, students. 3 moles of oxygen always changes into 2 moles of ozone. Both are gases. Ozonization. All oxygen is not converting into ozone. Everything we have discussed. Now, how much he has taken initially? 100 ml. Out of that, how much is going to react? We don't know. But finally, obtained ozonized oxygen, it means O3 plus O2 mixture. Finally, you got it as 80 ml. Now, what? How to solve? Same, 3 volumes will change us into 2 volumes. Out of 100, 3 moles. So, if I take it as 3x. 3x should change us to 2x. Because moles ratio is equal to volumes ratio. So, 3 volumes, 3x will be forming 2x volumes. Now, I am writing this. See, observe. Ozonized oxygen means mixture of ozone and oxygen. So, both you have to add. 100 minus 3x plus 2x. That exactly he has given as 80 ml in the question. Implies, so x equal to 20 ml. X equal to 20 ml. Now, volume of oxygen is equal to, what is the volume of oxygen left after reaction? 100 minus 3x. 100 minus 3 into how much x you got? 20. That is 40 ml. So, volume of ozone, that is 2x equal to 40 ml. Total 80 ml. So, 50-50. 1 is to 1 ratio. So, mole percent or volume percent, both are same, of oxygen and ozone, both are same, that is 50 is your answer. The same question can also be asked like this, students. What is the percentage conversion of oxygen in ozone? What is, concentrate students, what is the percentage conversion of oxygen into ozone? What is the oxygen volume given? 100. Out of that, how much is reacting? 3x. 3x is reacting. 3x means 60. So, out of 100, 60. So, percent of conversion of oxygen into ozone is 60. So, you can also get the question like that. So, whatever might be the question, we should be in a position to evaluate in the systematic way. So, in such case, we can able to answer any type of question asked based on the data given to us. Please note it down, students. Now I am going to introduce you the next type of stoichiometric calculations, that is determination of percentage yield of percentage yield of a chemical reaction determination of percentage yield of a chemical reaction. What is this yield? What is this? What is the actual application of this? First of all, we should know about that, then we will get interest to learn about this concept. In chemical industries, what usually the chemical engineers will do? They will sit in the AC rooms and they will just calculate on the paper, just like what we are doing in our on our board. And they simply give the orders like that. You can sit and you can fix the amount of reagent, raw materials needed, and how much of product we are going to get, you can simply calculate it. But in practice, actually, while going on, the process is going on in the industry, there will be many losses. Some material may be stuck to the pipes, the surface, the inner surface of the pipes, and transferring or shifting from one reactor to another reactor, there may be a lot of manual losses or technical losses will be there, and you never get 100% what exactly you have calculated on the paper or board. You will get some more less amount of product than you predicted. And this percentage yield is defined as actual, write down students, actual amount of product obtained
That is experimentally.
That is experimentally.
Theoretical theoretically calculated amount of product obtained into 100, this is to be fixed as percentage yield. This we can sit with pen and paper, you can, based on balanced chemical equation, you can simply calculate and you will get this much of product like this. But in practical, I have already told you, you will never get 100% yield. It is not that much easy, and very highly sophisticated techniques are needed. Of course, actual amount is always less than the predicted, theoretically calculated. That ratio into 100 should be called as percentage yield. The role of engineers in the industries is to increase this percentage yield. How are they going to increase the percentage yield? By increasing the actual amount of product what we are going to get in the industry. So, that is our next numerical approach that to be discussed under the heading of stoichiometric calculations. Students, with this, I am going to conclude this session today, and in the next session, I will explain the numerical approach based on this percentage yield. Thank you.